हेलो लर्नर्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन कोर्स ऑन फंक्शनल फूड्स एंड न्यूट्रास्यूटिकल्स। आई एम डॉक्टर रेखा शर्मा, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, UGC, ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट सेंटर, राष्ट्रीय संत तुकड़ोजी महाराज, नागपुर यूनिवर्सिटी, नागपुर। इन दिस मॉड्यूल वी शैल स्टडी कैप्सिसिन। द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस मॉड्यूल आर, आफ्टर स्टडिंग दिस मॉड्यूल स्टूडेंट शैल बी एबल टू डिस्क्राइब केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कैप्सिसिन, एक्सप्लेन एब्जॉर्प्शन, डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, systemic activity and bioavailability of capsaicin, describe health benefits of capsaicin. Capsaicin is an active component of chili peppers which plants are belonging to the genus capsicum contains. It is an irritant for mammals including humans and produces a sensation of burning in any tissues with which it comes in contact with. Capsicum fructacin is a vegetable used daily and the substance capsaicin is responsible for its hot and spicy flavor sought after in gastronomy. Capsaicin and several related molecules are known by the collective name capsaicinoids and they are produced by all plants of the genus capsicum with the exception of the bell pepper, that is Capsicum annuum, which produces no capsaicin. Capsaicin was discovered and extracted by Christian Friedrich Bollot in 1816, just 2 short years before his death. It received its current name in 1876, though Buchol originally called it capsaicin. The name itself comes from the genus of nightshade flowering plants from which it was originally extracted. The name capsaicin was applied to a colorless crystalline substance first isolated from capsicum oleoresin in 1876 and considered a single compound until about 1960. During the 1960s, the natural product was found to contain small amounts of other compounds very similar to the one for which the name capsaicin had become established. Now let us begin with the chemistry of capsaicin. The naturally occurring content of capsaicinoids in spices ranges typically from 0.1 mg per gram in chili pepper to 2.5 mg per gram in red pepper and 60 mg per gram in oleoresin red pepper. Capsaicin and dihydrocapsaicin are the major capsaicinoids produced. However, others exist and are produced in similar quantities. Although much of the capsaicin is found in the fruit of the plant, capsaicinoids have also been detected in the stem and leaves.
The Scoville heat unit scale is used to classify the strength of chili peppers.
Formula is C18H27NO3, molecular mass is 305.41 gram per mole. Solubility in water 0.0013 grams per 100 ml and crystal structure is monoclinic. It is clear dark red solid with high volatile with pungent odor and the melting point is 65. Now let us study absorption, distribution and systemic activity. Humans do not absorb capsaicin through their skin. In animals, capsaicin is absorbed by the stomach. Capsaicin moves throughout the body with the greatest amounts in the brain and spinal cord. The liver breaks down capsaicin. Both capsaicin and capsaicin bind with high affinity to the
TRPV1 receptor
and are passively absorbed with greater than 80% efficiency in the stomach and upper portion of the small intestine. Capsaicin is initially more stable than capsaicin and is metabolized by various cytochrome P450 enzymes in the liver. Capsaicin is cleaved earlier and is non-detectable in portal circulation.
Derivatives of capsaicin and capsaicate, including vanillyl amine, vanillin, vanillyl alcohol, and vanillic acid, are generated in both free and glucuronidated forms.
Once released in the circulation, albumin transports capsaicin to the adrenal gland, where it stimulates the release of catecholamines. Capsaicin-stimulated catecholamine release enhances lipolysis in the adipocytes, gluconeogenesis in the liver, and substrate oxidation in muscle. Now, coming down to bioavailability of capsaicin. After oral administration, the formulated capsaicin has prolonged plasma circulation, with the oral bioavailability increasing to 2.42-fold as compared with the free capsaicin. Additionally, a reduced irritation of capsaicin-loaded micelle on the gastric mucosa happens. This novel micellar formulation significantly improves the oral bioavailability of capsaicin and brings a series of notable advantages for its oral delivery. So let us conclude. In this section, we have studied chemical properties of capsaicin, absorption, distribution, systemic activity, and bioavailability of capsaicin. Now, in the next unit, we will study health benefits of capsaicin.